multiplied underneath you from the God and Father of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Maybe I'm the only one who these past couple of years has been dealing with situations that I just need to say, Lord, help me to hold out until my change comes. Will you join a song of sweet accord right in your virtual space and say, Lord, help me to hold out until my change comes. All of the stuff I'm dealing with. Come on and sing a song of sweet accord with my darling wife, Melissa, at this time. Come on, lift your voices, lift your voices, lift your voices.
Help me to hold out.
Insurrection. Money.
Help me to hold out.
Pandemic.
The devil's trying to get me down.
Death and dying, Lord.
Lord.
Real enemies.
Help me to hold out.
False friends. Temptations. Test. Tribulation.
Until my change.
If you need the help from my God and our Christ, why don't you lift your voice and say, Lord, help me to hold out. Watch and pray that you may not enter into temptation. The spirit is indeed willing, but the flesh is weak. Can I play that for you again? Watch and pray that you may not enter into temptation. The spirit is indeed willing, but the flesh is weak. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God stands forever. I want to use for our theological thought and our homiletical headline for this time that is ours to share, life on the edge of temptation. Yeah, I want to talk about living life on the edge of temptation. Beloved, written in 1980, but released in 1982, Grandmaster Flash and the Furious Five MCs in their song entitled The Message, amen, wrote this prominent hip-hop song that gave a commentary on a life, amen, of poverty. As a matter of fact, careful perusal of the song lyrics describes, amen, the stress of inner city poverty, amen, and in the final verses, amen, it describes how a child born in the ghetto without, amen, perspective in life is lured away, is tempted away into a life of crime. In other words, the song describes life on the edge of temptation, does it not? Can't you hear them saying in the song, crying out in this song, don't push me because I'm close to the edge and I'm trying not to lose my doggone head. It's like a jungle sometimes, and it makes me wonder how I keep from going, I wish I could get about two or three virtual comments of witnesses who can be truthful and testify and transparent and testify that at some point in your life you have lived a life on the edge of temptation. Is there anybody, amen, who can relate, amen, to this pandemic, this pandemonium that's going on around the world, amen, this insurrection and injustice, amen, that you have been close to the edge, amen, and you have been trying not to lose your head with everything that is going on associated even with this pandemic? Is there anybody who knows that these last 2 years of pandemic, pandemonium, and sad to say, prejudice, amen, has felt like a jungle sometime, and it makes us wonder if it had not been for the Lord who was on our side, our Lord God on our side, we might have gone under. Beloved, here is exactly where we find Jesus in Matthew 26 and 41, do we not? Can't you see him in the text? There he is in the Garden of Gethsemane. Can't you see him, amen, falling, amen, with his face on the ground in prayer? He's falling, amen, amen, on his face in prayer, in, amen, in a dark olive grove, is he not? And Jesus is, we find him in literal agony. Can't you see his suffering? Can't you feel his pain? So much so, the Bible says, amen, that his sweat was like drops of blood. He's on the edge, trying not to lose his head. It's like a jungle sometimes. It makes me wonder how even Jesus Christ kept from going under. He has prayed to his Father that it is possible when he take the cup of God's judgment from him. But man, though it all, he made it abundantly clear that he came to do the will of the Father. So he said, nevertheless, not my will, but thy will be done. So he submits to the Father's will in the text, does he not? But when he returns, he finds three of his most trusted disciples, the same ones he took up on the Mount of Transfiguration. He finds them, amen, physically and spiritually asleep, does he not? He finds them sleeping instead of watching. But I'm so glad that even if we become spiritually asleep, or we fall in spiritual sleep, amen, that Jesus found victory, amen, at the cross. Amen, he found it because of his successful struggle in Gethsemane, amen, through prayer. But Peter in the text, just like us, he fell in a later temptation because, as this text says, Peter fell, just like us at times, to watch and pray. And child of God, I want to let you know that our spiritual battles in life, amen, are often won and lost before the crisis in our life comes. You see, they're won and lost predicated upon, amen, our ability and our propensity to watch and pray, are they not? Well, you can consider point number one with me here. I want to talk about the evil cost caution against in temptation. I want to talk about this evil that is cautioned against in temptation. Will you take my hand and be my friend and walk around verse number 41 with me? Watch and pray that you may not enter in temptation. The spirit is indeed willing, but the flesh is weak. Child of God, I want to let you know that temptation, trials, and tests will come in your life. Temptation, trial, and tests will come in my life. You see, tests come in order to discover a person's nature or the quality of something, do they not? I want you to just think of yourself right now as a spiritual tube of toothpaste. In other words, people will never know what's on the inside of you until something squeezes you. And that's what I want to leave with you, beloved. That's why we got to have Jesus on the inside of us. So when a pandemic or a peril or a pandemonium or an insurrection or an injustice, amen, or amen, the malevolence, amen, or the disadvantages of life have a way of squeezing us, the Jesus on the inside of us, when we get squeezed, it will show up on the outside of us. And I've discovered something here. I've discovered, amen, through careful study, amen, and perusal of this pericope, that the context determines whether the intended purpose of the temptation is for good or evil. Let me play that for you again. I've discovered that the context determines whether the purpose of the, amen, temptation is for good or for evil. Are you with me here? Let me say it this way. Can I say it this way? Temptation says to you and I, friends, do this pleasant thing and don't be hindered by the fact that it's wrong. Are you with me here? But a trial, a test, amen, and a proven says, do the right and noble thing and do not be hindered by the fact that it is painful. Temptation is not painful. It says do it and don't worry about it, it's wrong. But when you're being tried by God, when you're being tested by God, and he allows a test to show up in your life, amen, it says that it's the right thing to do, even though it's painful. The easiest way, amen, is also often the sinful way. But sometimes the way that seems hard is the right way. Broad is the road to destruction, but narrow is the way that leads to life. No wonder Jesus taught his disciples to pray, lead me, in Matthew 6 and 13, not unto temptation. Lead me not into temptation, God. In other words, don't let me fail the test. Are you with me here? Beloved, there's no sin in being tempted. But when you fall to temptation, that's sin, and a lot of times it's our own fault. Because the Bible says there is no temptation that has overtaken man that God has not given him a way to escape. Yeah, it could have been that phone call that could have got you out of there, or that knock on the door. It could have been something that spooked you when you had your hands on the wrong thing, or your eyes on the wrong thing, or your mind on the wrong thing, that was trying to tell you to make a spiritual U-turn. There is no temptation that has overtaken any of us that God hasn't prevented and provided a way of escape. Child of God, I'm reminded of what Al Green said. He said, yield not to temptation, for yielding to sin, amen, each victory will help you, some other to win. He says, fight manfully on for. Amen. Dog present do. Look ever to Jesus and he will carry you through. We discussed this evil that is cautioned against, amen, concerning, amen, this temptation. Will you consider point number two with me? Will you still walk with me? Point number two in the text, and I'm not going to hold you long. I want to talk about the means of our success against temptation. The means of our success against temptation, and here it is, it's by not entering into it. Will you walk the text with me again? Watch and pray that you may not enter into temptation. The spirit is indeed willing, but the flesh is weak. Can I ask you a question predicated upon this pericope? How is temptation successful in our lives? Will you lay hands on your own self and say, self, how is temptation successful in my life? Beloved, the text is abundantly clear. Temptation is successful in people's lives because they enter into it. Notice the text. Notice in the text. Notice how prayer would help them to watch. Amen. And notice how watching would help them to pray. Let me say that for you again. Prayer will help us to watch, and watching will help us to pray. Notice the order of the commands. Notice the orders of the commands to watch and pray, how they precede the warning of temptation. Let me slow that down and play that for you again. Notice in verse number 41 of Matthew chapter 26, how the command, amen, to watch and pray precede, it comes before the warning about temptation. In other words, what are you saying, Brother Pastor? I'm glad to ask. I'm saying, don't wait until your temptation comes before you start watching and praying. You know what your thing is. You know what causes you to have stinking thinking. I know what causes me to have stinking thinking. I know what the things that you think about that you want to do that you know is wrong. You can't wait till those things show up. You got to watch and pray ahead of time. With somebody comment that and shout that and mean that I got to watch and pray ahead of time. Amen. In order to be successful against temptation. Here it is, the commands to watch and pray precede the warning about temptation, and we can't wait until the temptation comes to begin watching and praying. Amen. We gotta watch and pray before the temptation comes. Will you comment that? Will you shout that? Will you say that? I must watch and pray before the temptation comes. It's coming, y'all. And see, when you watch and pray before the temptation comes, you will be ready to deal with whatever temptation shows up. And much more likely, you will come through the testing victoriously. Will you not? I can hear some of you. Yeah, I can hear some of you. But, bro, Pastor, I've been on the battlefield a long time. I've been in the church a long time, bro, Pastor. I can sing the old hymns of the church. I know two or three scriptures, bro. Pastor, I'm strong. I got willpower. Has anybody ever thought that way, that nothing can touch you, that you were Jesus Jr. or Jesus Jr. yet because you have so much willpower? Can I tell you something here? And don't dodge me now. Take my hand and be my friend. Your willpower can't empower you to overpower temptation. Can I play that for you again? I don't care how much doggone willpower you have, Williams. It won't empower you to overpower temptation. Repeat after me. Willpower won't empower me to overpower temptation. Can I tell you why? Only the Holy Spirit can empower you to overpower the temptation that you face. That's why Jesus said, greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. Baby, you can't do it by yourself. That's why Jesus said, I'm not going to leave you comfortless. I'm going to give you the Holy Spirit on the inside. And if you allow the Holy Spirit to do a job on the inside, he'll show up on the outside. And when life squeezes you, when temptation squeezes you, what's on the inside? Oh, shucks, preach, boy. Lord, I'm doing the best I can. What's on the inside will show up on the outside. That's why Jesus says to you and I today, live our lives on the edge of temptation by watching and praying that we may not enter into temptation. Did your Bible read like mine in verse 41? The spirit is indeed willing. Amen, but the flesh is weak. The spirit is indeed willing, but the flesh is weak. The spirit is indeed willing, but this socks, this flesh, the spirit is indeed willing, this body, the spirit is indeed willing, but the flesh is weak. The spirit is indeed willing, but the flesh is weak. Jesus on the inside of us is willing, but our flesh is weak. Yeah, we're saved and we're on our way to glory. We are pilgrims passing through, but we got this same body with these same lips that used to lie, these same lips that sipped the booze, these same lips that smoked no damn cigarettes, these same lips and amen, hands that take stuff that wasn't ours, these same hands that touch forbidden bodies. We're in this body. Amen. We're in this flesh. This flesh is weak. That's why Paul said, oh, wretched man that I am, who can save me from this doggone body of flesh? Our spirits, Jesus on the inside of us is willing, but sometimes we allow this flesh to overcome. Watchfulness and prayer, child of God, are inseparable. Amen. One discerns danger and the other arms us against it. By watching, we're able to discern the danger that we face in temptation. And by prayer, we are armed against it. Ooh, Lord. That means, I'm about to get out of here. Yeah. We talked about the evil of temptation. Amen. And we talked about the success, amen, against temptation. Yes, but finally I want to talk about the way of preventing temptation. Amen. As I look at the text, the Bible says, amen, we prevent it by watching and praying. Yes, can't you hear the text saying watch and pray? Oh yes, that you may enter not in temptation. Your Bible read like mine. Amen. Spirit is willing. Oh yes, but the flesh is weak. Yes, watchfulness, amen, will keep us praying. Amen, and praying, yes, will keep us watchful. Yes, I want to let you know to watch without praying, that is presumption. Amen, and to pray without watching, yes, that is hypocrisy. You see, the greatest, amen, weakness, amen, may be our failure, amen, to ask God for his strength. Amen. Is there anybody who needs strength against your temptation? Yes, I double dog dare you to ask God to give you strength. Amen. I'm reminded of the 1962, amen, hit song by Bobby Bland. Yes, he wrote a song by, amen, a cheating woman. Yes, it was on the Duke record label. And Duke Records is located on Houston Street in Houston, Texas. Amen. I believe Bobby Bland was saying the same thing in the song that Jesus is saying to you and I today. Can't you hear Bobby Bland and Jesus saying, yield not to temptation. Amen. Oh, my love, while I'm away. Amen. Don't you know you gotta be strong and leave all those other guys alone. Amen. Because one fine sunny day, I'll be back home this day. So yield not to temptation. And then no one can lead you astray. Bobby Blue Bland, I believe Jesus is saying the same thing to you and I today. Amen. So many times you're going to be lonely. So many times you're going to be blue. But yield not to temptation. Yield not. Oh, yes. Yield not. Amen. Yield not to temptation. Baby, you got to be strong. You got to leave all that other stuff alone. Because one of these sunny days, amen, Jesus said, I'll be back on my way for home to stay. Yield not. Yield not. Yield not to temptation, for yielding to sin. Each victory will help y'all shut some others to win. Fight man for the honor. God passes to do. Look ever to Jesus. He will carry you through. Y'all know him, don't you? Born in Bethlehem, reared in Nazareth, ministered in Jerusalem, crucified and died on the Calvary. He is heaven's best. He is earth's only hope. He is hell's greatest fear. He's a meth the minute. He's a villain the son. But I call him Savior. I call him friend. I call him way maker. I call him helper. I call him covenant keeper. Y'all know him, don't you? His birth was a miracle. Baptism was a testimony. Preaching prayer changes things. You gotta watch. You gotta watch. You gotta watch and pray before temptation comes. And he's able. He's able to carry it through. How do I know? He climbed up Golgotha's hill. He hung his head and lost his shoulder. They nailed him in his hand. They nailed him in his feet. They pierced him in his side. They tried to tempt him to come off the cross. They said that you be the Christ. Come down and save yourself. He never came down. He hung his head and died. Didn't die. But it was early. Oh, shucks. Early. Let me try YouTube crowd. Will you shout? Early. Let me try the Facebook crowd. Will you shout? Early. On Sunday morning, he got up. Let me try the prayer line crowd. Didn't die. Didn't get up. He got up. He got up. Let me try the Zoom crowd. Didn't die. He got up with all power. Healing power. Saving power. Holy Ghost power. He got up so that you can get up out of any temptation. Beloved, there's no temptation that you have faced that Jesus had faced. You know, did they have meth and crack back then in the Old Testament time? No. They didn't have no meth and no crack. They didn't have that. For some of my older saints in Turkey Creek, they didn't even have rabbit tobacco. Am I bowling down somebody's alley? But what they had was the same thing that we have that tempts us. The lust of the eyes, the lust of this flesh, and the pride of life. Those are the three ways that we enter in sin and that we are tempted. Jesus was tempted with the lust of eyes, the lust of his flesh, and the pride of life. And he knew no sin. He's the sinless, matchless Lamb of God. And the only way that we can overcome temptation is by having him as our Lord and Savior and watching as well as praying. Watching without praying is presumption. Praying without watching is hypocrisy. Baby, you gotta watch and pray before your temptation and crisis come. Oh, it's coming. And the worst thing that we can do is look down on somebody else because they failed to a certain temptation. Well, what did you fall to? What did the preacher fall to? Watch as well as pray as we live our lives on the edge of temptation. Temptation shows up every day and you gotta be watchful and prayerful. Let them do Muhammad Ali no good to get in the ring with Mike Tyson and close his eyes. Mike Tyson will beat his head off and bite his ear off. He better watch while he's floating like a butterfly. He better pray while he's stinging like a bee. If not, he's gonna get his head knocked off his shoulders. Amen, somebody. Will you commit to watching and praying? If you have never accepted Jesus in your life and made him your choice, will you pray with me as you follow the information on the bottom of the screen? Lord, come into my life. Save my soul. I'm a sinner in need of a Savior. I believe that you suffered, bled, and died, and you're coming back again. That you are Lord to the glory of God the Father. I'm saved, and I'm truly saved. Because I've confessed in my mouth, and I believe in my heart. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. If you prayed that prayer, beloved, you're saved. You're in God's forever family. You can be no more unsaved than water can fall out of a well. Continue to follow the information on the screen. We would love to disciple you. If this is not the church you would like to be a part of, we will get you to that church. Just express that to us by calling us at 478-272-9169 or emailing us at turkeycreekb@gmail.com. Listen, somebody's been overtaken by a temptation. Might experience hormonal turbulence and forgot where your own bedroom is. Might be Dublin's or the country's biggest liar, gambler, cheater, mistreater, whatever it is. If you confess your sins to God, he's faithful to forgive you of your sins, amen, and cleanse you from all unrighteousness. That's what we mean by the word repent. Return, pent back to the top, to the pinnacle, back to God. Will you pray with me? Lord, I've blown. I'm saved, but I misstepped, misspoke, mistouched, misdone. Forgive me of my sins. Purge me with hyssop that I might be clean. Wash me that I might be whiter than snow. And God, thank you for giving me another chance. Thank you for your mercy, not giving me what I really deserve. And thank you for your grace, your unmerited favor in my life. In the name of Jesus, I pray for peace and strength. Amen. Beloved, God loves you. And if, whenever you misstep, because you will do it. I will do it. That's why don't lift me up on a pedestal, because I might disappoint you, because I'm human just like you. And we have to watch as well as pray. Amen. Listen, beloved, I want to rush to tell you, next Sunday, we're going to have two services, beloved. At 9:30, we're going to be on our campus outdoors for a communion fellowship service. You better get here on time, because we're going to start on time and we're going to end on time. And I plan on doing you like Miss Taylor did each and every one of us, but not hold you long. Again, we'll be at 9:30. We'll start and we'll have a communion fellowship. There will be a little singing and preaching and communion, and we will be out as we then get ready for our 11 o'clock service that will be in the virtual space as it always is. We thank God for being a resource church to be able to, amen, share the gospel in so many ways. So tell someone also, please let us know how many people will be coming with you to the service, because we're going to have a little, as we say in the country down here below, making some tea. We're going to have a little something for you to knock the hanks off for you till you get back home. Please let us know how many will be in your vehicle with you. We're going to ask that you can sit outside your vehicle in chairs that you might bring, or inside your vehicle, or on your hood, or on the back of your truck, however you do what you do. But we will be here on the campus at 9:30. In person, out on the yard, and then we will be back in the virtual space at 11 a.m. Two services on next Sunday, amen. Communion fellowship, fall communion fellowship service, amen. At this time, let us now receive our announcements from the bottom.
Greetings from the news desk at Turkey Creek Missionary Baptist Church, where Dr. Frederick C. Williams is the pastor. My name is Devon Watson, and I am here to bring you this week's news from the Creek. Monday prayer line will be at 7 a.m. and 9 p.m. The toll-free number is 1-302-202-1110. The conference code is 777-581. And now for this week's prayer request.
This week's prayer request, we have Annie L. Lowry, Osnola Davis, Mother Christine Baker, Hattie Thomas, Marie Smith, Martha Farmer, Lucille Collins, Latrell Roach, Joyce Tyson Williams, all PK through 12 and college students, Vaughn London, Pat Rooks, Victoria Wright, McKinley Williams, Mary Mitchell, Wilbert Roberts, Ella Lee Way, Stevie Ward, James Cartwright, Carla Cartwright, Deacon Richard Hunter, Brother Wes Moy, Spence Mullis, Ernestine Woodard, Quincy Woodard, Ricky Million, Derek McLeod, Wanda Parker, Annie Winston, Altmise Gordon, Ruby Stanley, the Baker family, Curtis Boone, Jackie Curtis, Yolanda J. Guyton and family, the Cartwright family, Emma Ruth Savage, Deacon William Burwell and family, Beatrice Bird, Dr. Susan Thornton, Charles Berry, the Jenkins family, Deacon Nathaniel Howard, the Manning family, the Reeves family, the Wilbur family, Michael Berry, Angela Hall.
And now for this week's birthdays.
Today, we'd like to wish a very happy birthday to Gerald Edmond, September 26th. This week's birthdays, we have Deacon Vernon Howard, October 2nd, and Christopher Moore, October 2nd.
Friends, it is giving time. There are three ways to give tithes and offerings to the Creek. The first, you may mail your gifts to 1164 Williewood Road, East Dublin, Georgia, 31027. Or you may use our Cash App. Our cash tag is the $ lowercase TCMBC 828. Again, our cash tag is the $ lowercase TCMBC 828. You may also give by logging on to our secure website, www.turkeycreekbaptistchurch.org, and click on the giving link. Then follow the easy instructions on the screen. Again, log on to our secure website, www.turkeycreekbaptistchurch.org, and click on the giving link. Then follow the easy instructions on the screen. Please remember, Paul told the Corinthians church in 2 Corinthians, the 9th chapter, verses 6 through 7, in the English Standard Version. The point is this: whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and whoever sows bountifully will also reap bountifully. Each one of us must give as he has decided in his heart, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. Thank you for sharing in your giving.
Here's a spiritual challenge for you. Will you commit to praying for the salvation of one lost person and seek opportunities to share the gospel with him or her? It can be a friend, relative, coworker, classmate, or acquaintance. It can even be an enemy. After all, Jesus did tell us to love our enemies and pray for those who persecute us in Matthew chapter 5, verse 44. Pray and invest in one person the Lord places on your heart that needs Christ. Make a commitment today. Identify your one. Begin praying daily for your one and seeking opportunities to tell them about Jesus and invite them to church. Will you commit? Who's your one?
Turkey Creek and Guest, we're encouraging all members to get vaccinated as soon as possible. If you have already been vaccinated, please contact your deacon and let them know. We will also be sending out a survey to see who has been vaccinated. If you need assistance getting vaccinated, please call 478-272-9169. We look forward to a safe return. Sunday, October 3rd, is Holy Communion. Please have your sacraments ready. October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. October is also Clergy Appreciation Month.
This has been your weekly news from the Creek. My name is Devonna Watson, and I hope to see you all next Sunday. Have a blessed day.
Thank you so much, Devonna, for the announcements, and thank everyone in your respective places. Listen, beloved, we look forward to seeing you at 9:30 in person on the yard next Sunday. Amen. But also, we would love to see you in the virtual space at 11 a.m. as well. At the 9:30, we will have it on Facebook, and at the 11th, it'll be on all of our social platforms, amen, out on the yard, amen, at 9:30, and all virtual spaces at 11, amen. Let us receive the benediction. The Lord bless thee and keep thee. The Lord make his face to shine upon thee. The Lord be gracious unto thee, lift his countenance upon thee, and give you peace. Go in peace as you live life on the edge of temptation to love and serve the Lord. Let us lift our voice and sing together. Bless your people as we live life on the edge of temptation. Let us glorify you. We trust you. We need you. Send your power, God, as we live life on the edge of temptation. Oh, God, bless you, Lord. Help us, God. Keep us, God. Hold us, God. Bless your people that are tuned in, God. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Oh, Listen, beloved, if you live your life on the edge of temptation, know that we love you at the Turkey Creek Church, and there's nothing you can do about it. Have a blessed week.